ata tayo ng mag-aral sa math, walang maiiwan. At sayang mag-aral tayo ng matuto upang di kayo masenso. Maging matyaga, maging matalino, halina mag-aral na tayo. Maging matyaga, maging matalino, halina mag-aral na tayo. Halina mag-aral na tayo. Halina mag-aral na tayo. Halina, 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 aral na tayo.
Salamat sa napakahusay na pagtuturo, Teacher Richard. Ngayon, dumako na tayo para sa ating senior high school. Akin nang ipakilala ang guro na ating makakasama na siyang magtuturo ng probabilities under the normal curve. Siya ay nagtapos sa Kalinga Tapayao State College bilang Bachelor of Secondary Education major in Mathematics. At may kumpletong academic requirements ng Master of Arts majoring in Mathematics sa Philippine Normal University. Ang teacher ito ng Senior High School sa Addition Hills Integrated School, walang iba kundi si Teacher Julie M. Morta.
Masaya at magandang araw sa ating lahat. Nagpapasalamat po ako sa pagkakataon na maging kabahagi ng Project SOAR sa pamamagitan ng aming Education Program Supervisor in Mathematics, Sir Estituto Rodelas, at sa aming napaka-supportive na principal, Ma'am GGG Bulanday. Teachers, home learning partners, at higit sa lahat sa mga batang manduno, magandang araw! Handa na ba kayo? Ihanda na ang inyong ballpen, notebook, at module. At tara na, samahan ninyo ako sa isang matkabuluhang hapon. Matsayang mag-aral, matsayang matuto.
Good day! Today, we will discuss Quarter 3, Week 9 of your Clyde Learning Module under the subject Probability and Statistics. And our lesson for today is probabilities using the standard normal distribution table. Now, let us discuss first the lesson objective. We have at the end of this learning episode, you are expected to compute probabilities using the standard normal distribution table. Let us discuss first the definition of terms that we will use throughout the lesson. First, we have the standard normal distribution. The standard normal distribution or the normal curve is the probability of a continuous random variable, and it is used to determine the probabilities. Next, we have the term z-score. Z-score represents the distance between a given measurement x and the mean, expressed in standard deviations. And then next, we have probabilities associated with standard normal random variable. It can be depicted as areas under the standard normal curve. Hence, an area can be expressed as a probability. So when we're talking about the area under the normal curve, we are also talking about its probability. Next, we have here the four-step process in finding the area or the probability under the normal curve given any z value. Express the given z value into a three-digit form. Using the z table, find the first two digits on the left column. Match the third digit with the appropriate column on the right, and then read the area or probability at the intersection of the row and the column. I will illustrate to you this one. Next, we have the Z table. The Z table is the table of areas under the normal curve. Now, this is the full view of the areas under the standard normal curve. So, in here, if we zoom it out, we have this one. So, as you can see here, we have the table rows and then the table columns. The table rows here shows the whole number and the 10th place of the z-score. The table columns, it shows the 100th place of the z-score. Now, this one, the 4-digit values here are your areas. So, let's say your z-score is 1.14, you get the intersection of your row and column. So, let's say 1.14. So, we have 1.1 plus 0.04. So, get the intersection. So, we have 1.1. Then, if you add 1.1 plus 0.04 is 1.14. So, we have this one. So, the intersection is 0.3729, and that will be used as your area for 1.14. So, from the mean to 1.14, the area is 0.3729. Next, we have also here the areas under the normal curve illustration. So, in here, we have here a normal curve, and as you can see, the center is zero, or that is your mean. And then we have here negative 1, negative 2, and then negative 3 z values. Then we have positive 1, positive 2, and positive 3 z values. Now, the area from the mean going up to positive infinity, or this right side of the normal curve, is 0.5 or 50%. And the area of the left side of the curve, the whole left side of the curve, is also 0.5 or 50%. And then the total area of the standard normal distribution is 1 or 100%. Next, we have also here the summary table in getting the areas under the normal curve. The first column is your common words used, the sign, notation, and the illustration, and then the operation that will be used to get the area. So, if you read these words, greater than, to the right, at least, more than, and above, and the sign is positive, the notation looks like this. P of Z greater than A. If we formally read this one, we have the probability that a standard normal random variable Z is greater than a given value A. If we talk about probability, we also are talking about the area. So, we have here the probability of P of Z greater than A. So, we have this one. This shaded portion here, wherein you will use the value of your Z value from 0 to this one, this line here, to get the shaded area. So, to do that one, we have to subtract the whole area of your right side minus the area from 0 up to whatever the value of this or your given. So, subtract the area corresponds to the given from 0.5. So, 0.5 is from the area of the whole of this right side. Next, we have also same words used, but we have a sign which is negative, meaning the given z value is negative. So, the notation that will be used is P of Z greater than negative A. So, meaning the given Z value is negative. Since we have the words greater than to the right at least, so going to its right. So, you're looking for the area of this shaded region here. So, what are you going to do to solve for the area of this or the probability? So, you have to add, correct? So, add 0.5 to the corresponding area of your Z value. Why do you need to add? It is because it covers all your right side and this one. So to get this all of this shaded area, you have to add 0.5. Next, what if we have less than, at most, no more than, not greater than, or to the left? And your sign is positive. The notation here is P of Z less than A. So again, if we read this one, the probability that a standard normal variable Z is less than a given value A. To illustrate this one, so this is less than, meaning the shaded part is to the left. We're looking for the area or probability of the shaded portion. So if we are given a positive Z value, we have to add 0.5. And add 0.5 plus the corresponding area of your given Z value. And then same words use, less than, at most, no more than, not greater than, to the left, and the sign is negative, the notation that you will use is P of Z less than negative A. So to illustrate this one, we have this. So your Z value is negative, and then since less than, going to the left, right? So the shaded part is here. So what are you going to do to get the area of the shaded part is to subtract. You subtract the given area of from 0 to negative Z from 0.5. So subtract the area corresponds to the given from 0.5. So why do you need to subtract? Because you are just looking for the shaded part. Next, we have the common used word is between. So the sign of the given Z value is negative and positive. The notation that you will use is P of Z greater than A but less than B, or the probability of Z greater than A but less than B. To illustrate this one, so we have two Z values. One is negative, the other one is positive. And you are looking for the probability or the area between those two Z values or the shaded portion. The operation that you will use is you have to add the two corresponding areas. So whatever the area of this one, the Z table, and from mean to negative Z value, then you have to add to get the total area of the shaded portion here. We also have a common use word still is between, but the sign is you have two positive Z values. Again, we have your notation same as this, which is the probability of Z greater than A and Z less than B, because you are given a Z value which is one is greater than the other. Of course, the one that is smaller in value will have the place of your A, and then the other, which is bigger in value, will have the place for B. So in here, the illustration will look like this. So we have your first Z value and then the second Z value, and you are looking for the probability between them or the area between those two Z values. In here, what are you going to do to get the area? You have to subtract. So subtract the two corresponding areas. So whatever the area from 0 to Z1 or Z square 1 and then 0 to Z square 2, you have to subtract to get the probability or the area of the shaded portion or in between them. And then lastly, we have, if you are given two negative Z values, still the notation looks like this, P of Z greater than A but Z is less than B. The only difference in here is you are given two negative Z values. This is the illustration. You are looking for the area or probability between these two negative Z values. So in here, the shaded portion, same as this one. So you have to subtract the two corresponding areas. So to sum up, we have this illustration. We have to the left of any Z value, if you are given a positive Z value and you are looking for the area to its left, you have to add 0.5 plus the corresponding area. But if you are given a negative Z value and you are looking for the area or probability to its left, you have to subtract from 0.5. If you are given a negative z value and to its right, you have to add 0.5 plus corresponding area. But if you are given a positive z value and you're looking for the area to its right, you have to subtract 0.5. And then next, if you are given between two z values, if you are given two positive z values or two negative z values, and you're looking for the probability or area between them, you have to subtract the two z values. But if you are given one negative z value and one positive z value, and you're looking for the area in between them, or the probability in between them, you have to add the two z values. Example number one, find the proportion of the area greater than z, which is equal to 1.21. So in here, I will present to you the solutions step by step so that you will not be confused. So the first step is to sketch the normal distribution and indicate the mean. The mean coincides with z, which is equal to 0. So for the solution, we have here the illustration. Take note that the mean is equal to 0. So from the left side, we have from negative 1 up to negative 3. And for the right side, we have from positive 1 up to positive 3. For step 2, we have identify the region under the curve by drawing vertical line through the z, which is equal to 1.21, and shade the required region. So we have to plot where is that 1.21, and then we have to locate the area greater than the given. So in here we have your 1.21. You know that 1.21 is just between 1 and 2. So take note, we'll just do a rough estimate. So we have to shade the area greater than this. So the area greater than that is the area going to its right. So the shaded area now will be our task. If how many percent or what is the area of this shaded portion? And for step 3, we have determine the area of the shaded region. So we have to plot the 1.21 given, and then we shaded the area greater than 1.21 and its area to its right. So to determine the shaded area, okay, the shaded portion here in the illustration, we have to get first the area from 0 to 1.21. From 0 to 1.21, to get the area of this, we have to refer to the z table. So we will look for the area for 1.21. So again, to use the z table, you refer first for the rows up to 10th place. So we have 1.2, and then add the 100th place, which is 0.01. So 1.2 plus 0.01 is 1.21. So we have the intersection now is 0.3869. This is now the area of 1.21. Let's go back to the illustration. So the area from 0 to 1.21 is 0.3869. Now, you know that from 0 up to all of this on the right side of the normal curve is equivalent to 0.5 or the 50%. To get the shaded portion or shaded area, we have to subtract 0.5, the whole of this side, all of this area, the right side, to this one, 0.3869. So with, of course, proper notation. So for step 4, we have to compute now for the proportion of the area of the required region. Now, to compute for the area, again, we have to subtract 0.3869 from 0.5. So, we have here the proper notation, P of Z greater than Z, which is 1.21, which is now equal to 0.5 minus 0.3869. This one. The area from 0 to 1.21, 0.3869. If we subtract this, we get the difference, which is equal to 0.1131 or 11.31%. So thus, the proportion of the area under the curve greater than 1.21 is 0.1131 or 11.31%. So this one, the shaded area is equal now to 11.31%. Let us take this example number 2. Find the proportion of the area less than Z, which is equal to 1.21. Same steps. So first, we have to sketch the normal distribution. So we have from 0 and then to the left side, negative 1 to 3. And then from the right side, we have positive 1 to and 3. For step 2, identify the region under the curve. So again, I've used same Z value so that we know that we will not be looking again and again in the Z table. We will be using same area value. So where is that 1.21 in the normal curve? So again, it is between 1 and 2. So in here, again, it is a rough estimate. But the only difference is that we will be computing for the area less than this given Z value. So the area less than this is the area below or to the left of the given Z value, which is 1.21. So therefore, the shaded part of the region, the shaded part of the illustration is all of the left side from 1.21 going to its left. Next, for step 3, we have to determine the area of the shaded region. So to determine the area of the shaded region now, we have to plot first the area of the given. You notice here, class, that all of the left side of the curve was shaded. So since it is shaded, automatically that the area of this whole left side is 0.5. Now, from the Z table presented earlier, the area from 0 to 1.21 is 0.3869. To get now the area of the shaded, the whole of this shaded region, we are now going to add. We add these two areas to get the whole area of the shaded region. So we have our step 4. Again, you use the proper notation. So we have now probability of Z less than 1.21. That is equal to 0.5 plus 0.3869. So to add this one, the sum will be 0.8869 or 88.69%. So thus, the proportion of the area under the curve less than Z, which is equal to 1.21, is 0.8869 or 88.69%. Again, this is the shaded portion and it is equivalent to 88.69%. Let's go to example number 3. Find the proportion of the area between Z is equal to negative 1.21 and Z is equal to 1.21. So in here, we have here two Z values, positive and negative Z values. So again, same process. Step 1, we have to sketch the normal curve. And then the normal curve consists of your mean, which coincides with 0. And then left side, negative 1 to 3. And then right side, positive 1 to 3. And then we have to plot where is this negative 1.21 and Z, positive 1.21, in the normal curve. So again, we have here, your positive 1.21 is between 1 to 2. And your negative 1.21 is between negative 1 and negative 2. So we are looking for the proportion of the area between them. So in here, it is the shaded portion. Now, to look for the area, we have to determine first the corresponding area of the given. So in here, they have the same z value. So there's no such thing as negative area. That is why all of the areas are all positive. They are just the same area, which is 0.3869. Again, we got this 0.3869 from the z table. Same thing with this, since they have same z value, we have 0.3869. To get the area, the proportion of the area between them, we have to add. We have to add the two areas. We have 0.3869. Again, use the proper notation. So since your z is in the center, should be greater than negative 1.21. and less than 1.21. Again, whatever the value that is lesser than the other will be the first one that you are going to list down, so that you will not be confused. So we have 0.3869 plus 0.3869. So if we add, our sum will be 0.7738 or 77.38%. So therefore, the proportion of the area under the curve between z, which is equal to negative 1.21 and positive 1.21, is 0.7738 or 77.38%. So again, the shaded portion is 77.38%. So these are my references in this video lesson. So thank you so much for listening. Again, this is your lecturer for today, Miss Julie Lopez Morta. Thank you so much.